think we might die here.
This was the first time I heard David say, you know, Mark, I think we might. I think we might die.
It must be those rocks the lion was talking about.
But somewhere they've gone horribly wrong. Instead of the safe route down they were expecting, they've reached a sheer 200-foot drop.
We could not see any way down it.
It's a dead end.
There's no way down.
Their water has run out, their leader has collapsed, and the three 15-year-old boys are on their own. Their desperate bid to reach the Colorado River is over. It's the final straw. They've run into a dead end, a sheer 200-foot drop.
What do we do?
I don't know, Mark. Nothing, I guess.
The river's out of reach. And with the group not expected back for six more days, there's no hope of anyone sending out a search party in time. Now, all they can think of is getting out of the sun. Back up the canyon, scout leader Guy is also losing hope. Out of sheer desperation, he comes up with a plan to make himself visible to any passing planes.
As I laid there, I knew that it would be hard for someone to see me because I was down below the level. I took out a emergency blanket.
Guy is totally alone and virtually helpless. It's his darkest hour.
When I realized how much of my strength it took just to do that, I was absolutely certain that there was no way out without help from somebody else.
Sheltering under clifftop boulders, the boys realize they face a slow and painful death from dehydration.
In my mind, I knew we were gonna die. You're weak. Your body hurts and aches. You have headaches. I just remember not knowing if I'd ever get up from that position. I remembered that could be the last place I'd be, is under that rock.
That was a pretty sad situation there, you know. Now I was almost turned 16. I wasn't gonna get to drive or anything. You know, you think about your family, that you're not gonna see your mom again or your dad, and it's really sad.
Even David, the optimist of the group, is struggling to see a way out.
I'd asked David a couple times by now, David, do you think that we're gonna make it? Are we gonna die?
We are gonna make it, aren't we?
And most of the time he'd be like, oh, Mark, of course we're gonna make it. You're fine, don't worry about it, okay?
I think we might die here.
But this was the first time I heard David say, you know, Mark, I think we might. I think we might die.
Hey, George, can you get me a pen?
Why?
I want to write a letter to my mom and dad, you know. say goodbye.
Don't be stupid, Dave. We're not gonna die.
I was telling him that, not to give us confidence or not to give us hope. But I almost said it just so that I didn't have to go get him one. So I didn't want to move from that spot. I physically couldn't. I was just gonna lay there to die, and I didn't want to do anything else.
The boys start to drift in and out of consciousness.
I had a dream of myself in a coffin. You know, my family walked by, but my littlest brother just broke down in tears, covered his eyes.